If you want to learn how to make this St. Patrick's Day gnome, then just keep on watching. The supplies I used to make this cute little St. Patrick's Day gnome were all from Dollar Tree. I used one of these St. Patrick's Day knee-high socks. We're just using the bottom portion of the sock. I picked up one of these little hats. They had them in different styles. That was my favorite one. And I also found this little orange pom-pom that is from Dollar Tree. I found it in the craft section. Typically used for winter hats. You're also going to need 4 cups of rice and a grocery bag. We're going to need a hot glue gun, some scissors of your choosing, and a wooden bead to make the little nose. So the first thing that I did was take just one of the socks and I cut it at an angle so I was able to tie the top of it. So I made sure that it was an angle of some sort. It doesn't really matter what type of angle, as long as it's an angle. So as you can see, the top portion of it is angled. Now we're going to stuff the sock with the rice. But instead of just putting the rice down into the sock, I'm going to put it into this grocery bag first. That way it has something kind of around the rice and it won't like get a bunch of bugs or something inside this. I'm hoping that the plastic bag will kind of protect the rice from bugs. The great thing about using like a grocery bag is that the plastic is so thin that you're still able to move your little gnome around a little bit and it doesn't feel like there's a bunch of plastic in there, like a hard plastic or anything like that. It just feels like it's rice. So after I poured most of the rice in, I just kind of shook the bag so that the rice would settle down to the bottom, and then I poured the rest in and kept doing that until I was done pouring all 4 cups of rice in. After that, I then cut the bag. And then I tied a double knot on the bag so that none of the rice would fall out of the bag and into the sock and make a mess or anything like that in the inside of it. And then I repeated the same process with the sock. I tied a double knot. Then to make sure that none of this came undone, I hot glued these pieces down in place. All right, now it's time to move on to the pom-pom. Just take it off of the tag here. I'm just gonna simply cut the strings because we don't really need them. Then taking your scissors or a knife or something sharp, I actually poked down into the bottom where the string was tied to. It's actually all kind of sewn up right here into a ball. So you kind of have to like pick at it a little bit with your fingers and stretch and pull this thing apart and it will come undone. And it's actually just fabric that's wrapped up in a circular form that's stuffed with more fabric. I'm just showing you guys what was inside there. So now I'm going to just take off the little black pieces of this and lay this flat. So we want to make sure we recognize, you know, which direction this fur is going on the fabric. So I'm pushing it all down in one direction with my fingers just to make sure it does lay pretty nicely. And then that'll be the way we glue it on to the sock. We'd obviously want it all pointing down. So I just hot glued this guy in place. And that pretty much finishes up the beard. So we're almost done already with our gnome. So now that I want to make sure the nose is in the correct place, so I actually take the hat and just kind of pop it on the top to see where it would sit. And then I'll take the bead and place it where I want it, which is just underneath the hat, right about here. So this will be where I glue the bead. So I want to make sure all that fur is laying flat so when I glue the bead, it'll be nice and secure. And the last step is just to hot glue the hat down to the body. And I just put just glue in the inside circle right here. I went over 2 times because this is a little bit riggedy. It wasn't like smooth. I wanted to make sure that every little area had glue. And then I just popped it down, making sure that the gold piece was lined up with the nose. And we are done making our gnome. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you leave me a thumbs up and a comment below. I love saying hello to all of you. And you guys have a happy St. Patrick's Day.